You know, I wished I'd brought some gloves or something, but Buddy told me it's warmer weather out east. Like, the further I get, sort of the warmer it'll get. So I'm looking forward to sort of finding my way across. I never really wanted my own car again so bad. Like, I totally missed my Cutlass, I'm not gonna lie. Like, I kind of wish I could just have a sort of a vehicle and a shelter at the same time. What brings you to Winnipeg?
I'm making a movie.
Oh, right.
I'm an actor.
Oh, cool. Like, dinner theater and stuff too, or like?
Well, I'm an actor, and I guess people can eat while they watch me if they want. So,
oh,
yeah.
Right. Yeah, like, okay, yeah.
At lunch, they can eat any meal they want.
You know, I heard like actors are always like, you probably do a little waitering too there now and then, you know, like.
I haven't done it in years. 20.
Are you serious?
7 years.
Wow, I've never even heard of an actor that doesn't, you know, on the side.
I was a terrible waiter.
Yeah, I never seen in anything, so you probably, you know, little one of them little movies or something, whatever. So,
uh-huh. And yeah. Studio movies.
Are you fucking serious? You're in a studio movie?
Yeah.
Oh, like you're in the front of the, you're an actor in a studio movie.
Sometimes.
Bullshit. You serious? How come you don't have like a limousine or like driving a normal car or whatever?
I like driving myself.
Oh. Because I always figured if you're like a studio movie guy,
yeah,
like
you have to be in a limousine all the
yeah,
time.
Yeah, like tinted out windows.
You're not allowed to go outside.
Yeah.
Except in a limo.
Yeah, that's what I figured. But
yeah, no, I understand.
There. Oh, your phone. If you need to.
No, it's
all
right.
Okay,
it's
yeah.
Just my agent telling me I have another big role.
Oh, you shut up. You seriously got an agent? Wow. Yeah, well, no, like.
So that's my agent telling me I have to turn down a couple $1 million.
Oh, yeah, right. You're hilarious, man. That's so funny. Funny you say that, because I wasn't in a movie, but.
Right.
I was a subject of a documentary. See, this is one that I built. 42-inch DeWill. Feels thick, eh? How thick would you say that table feels? Table's actually only that thick. That's why it's called a double edge. Makes it look a lot thicker. This is solid oak.
He would not be doing anything other than the manual lifting of furniture in and out of the truck and into a person's home.
Push it through and it rips it in half.
You don't do nothing else.
You know, my buddy there, he had like ball cancer in there, and they had to like lob off one of his nuts. When I seen it, I was like, that's not exactly what happened. You know, like they cut out some of the things where I was
that's
like,
Hollywood.
Hey guys, like look at my wallet. I do have a couple 20s. But
yeah.
In the movie, they were like, oh, this guy's got fuck all. So I was a bit mad about that.
I play a lawyer on a show.
You can't pretend to be a lawyer. You gotta be a lawyer.
On a TV show, you can.
No. Bullshit. To be a lawyer on TV, you have to be a real one. Because then how do you know what to say?
Well, the writers tell you what to say.
Oh, so the writers are lawyers. Like, Rambo's Rambo. Like, he actually went to war. That's how they got it to seem so real, because they're like,
yeah.
He knows about war.
No, he's not real at all. And,
what the fuck?
I'm sorry to make confused.
I don't actually get out to watch a lot of stuff.
Most movies are made up.
Yeah, see, that I thought...
It's not real.
I thought to be a part, you had to, like, know it. Like, if you're going to play a... If, let's say, you're going to play a welder, how would you know, like, where
how to...
do
it?
Yeah, like,
well, you have to have a welder show you how to move your arms and stuff. But mostly, they probably wouldn't let you weld because it's dangerous. Well, if I ever play a welder, and now I'm starting to get ideas.
Yeah. Oh, that...
For movies.
Oh, you could be a welder. I could teach you. You could be like, hey, dog fucker, get over here. It's hard work. Like, you're out there all day grinding away.
Yeah.
The smoke ain't good for you, so like...
But do they have welders competitions?
That's a good question. I know they have lumberjack. Like,
be a hell of a movie.
Oh, fuck.
Guy from nowhere has never welded anything.
Yeah.
Nobody believes in him.
Yeah.
He sees a welder.
Uh-huh.
He thinks, maybe I can do that. He secretly welds in his bedroom.
Fuck yeah.
At night for hours and hours.
Put me in it.
The young kid who's like the hot welder gets sick and they have an open spot and the old man gets in.
Right.
And
how is this happen? How
and
do you
he wins.
How do you know the whole movie without even seeing it?
I just basing it on every other movie that's ever been made.
Oh, right. That's smart.
What would we call it?
I don't know, like weld or die. Like get welding or no, welding, die trying welding. No, welding, die.
Well, name some things that you use in welding.
Oh, you use rod?
Rod.
Rod's what you burn. And maybe the guy's rod's Like, right. It could be a
rods of steel.
Yeah, rods of steel. Fuck, man, you got a special brain there. Because I would have taken, like, I would have had to smoke some dubs and have some beers, and then I maybe would have come up with
an idea.
Yeah, like, after that, then that's when the...
Maybe I already did that already.
Oh, you shouldn't be driving. Well, I don't even care, you know, it's all right. You're doing great. Back in the day, I could hitchhike everywhere. Now it's getting harder and harder, but if this
welding movie ever comes together...
Well, yeah, and seriously, if you ever need an actual real job... What was your name again there?
Bob.
Bob, nice to meet you, man. Yeah, I'll look you up. Good luck in Hollywood.
Yeah, thank you.